The very last thing we're going to talk about in section 4 is auditing. It is one of the most important things that you can do in Go Incognito, so do not take it lightly. When we think of auditing, we think of inspections, uneasiness, error finding, and let's just be real, that is what it is. But auditing is very important. Your privacy and security etiquette is going to change over time. Either you're going to slowly start slacking off, or you're going to want to continually be improving your habits. Additionally, technology is always evolving, so things that worked when you started may need to change. For example, when two-factor authentication was being popularized, it was mostly used with email and phone numbers, which, as we discussed in section 3, are susceptible to attacks. Now, many services implement apps that handle two-factor authentication offline with OTP, something you all should be utilizing. Changes like this happen constantly, and it's important for you to keep up with news related to these topics. Whether it's through Reddit, a news source, us, make sure you're continually keeping up to date. We have surveillance reports uploaded every week, offered as a video and a podcast if you want an easy way to keep up with this kind of news. In order to make sure you're always protected, you will need to self-evaluate your privacy and security habits. I broke up auditing into different steps to help you out. Premium users of Go Incognito can refer to the checklist once that's done. Hello there, and thanks for watching Go Incognito. This course is entirely free, and one of the ways we can do that is through our many supporters who believe in our mission in spreading privacy and security to the masses. If you enjoy our work and want to help our cause, we have perks for supporters on Patreon and YouTube, and we recently introduced one-time donations through Ko-fi and PayPal. The latter needs no account on your end. We also accept Monero for those wanting to donate with the utmost privacy in mind. Thank you to all our current supporters, thanks to all of our future supporters, and thank you for watching the free course. Enjoy the rest of the lesson. 1. Check have I been pwned, and search for your personal information through a search engine for hacks and leaks of your personal information. If anything has been compromised, you need to make sure you secure your account by changing your password, and ideally the email associated with the password. Go back to Go Incognito 2.4 and 3.4 for more instructions on what to do in this scenario. 2. Check for updates on every device you own and every piece of software on that device. We covered why this is important in lesson 3.2. 3. Run anti-malware scans on your devices that have a higher risk of infection. This will be most desktop operating systems, even Linux. Malware was covered in lesson 3.12. 4. Update all of your passwords, at least for your most sensitive accounts. Sometimes hacks and leaks aren't publicized, so someone may have access to an account without your knowledge. Additionally, continually changing your passwords will make it difficult for somebody to brute force their way into your accounts using computational power. I covered these topics in lesson 3.4 and 3.5. 5. Check up on your phone's settings, apps and app settings. Make sure no recent apps you downloaded have unnecessary permissions. Shopping apps don't need your microphone, and calculators don't need your location. Go to lesson 3.3 for more details. 6. Delete unneeded files, photos, programs, and apps. What I tend to find is I'll try a few apps and forget to delete them, and the audit will typically catch these, as well as any settings for new apps I haven't configured yet. Refer to the minimalism lesson in 2.2 to recover this. Don't forget to clear your temporary files like history, cache, and cookies as well. 7. Try to ask a friend to dig up information on you online. If they found more than you'd like, you need to ask them where they got the information so you can remove or falsify it. You can also do this yourself if you don't have any friends that don't want to do it for you. 8. Whatever you want, it's your decision. The other things we covered I recommend you always check up on, but you may have different priorities and things to look at. Section 5 will talk about physical security and privacy, and some of you may have things in there that you'd like to audit. I'd encourage you to find what's important for your personal interests, priorities, and threat models, and add those things to your list of items to consistently check up on. Like I said before, auditing is an extremely important part of increasing your digital privacy and security over time. You can configure everything properly in January as a New Year's resolution, but in 6 months, you can be completely vulnerable just like you were in December. Stay on top of things. I recommend you set aside a day every week, other week, month, or every other month to sit down and audit yourself. The frequency is your decision and where you draw your convenience line. I wish you luck. Thank you so much for watching this lesson, and I will see you in the finale of section 4, where we're going to recap everything we learned.